In Angular, we can now create variables for reuse right within our component templates. Now that might seem odd, but it's actually pretty cool. If you're like me, you may have a hard time understanding the benefits at first. So in this video, I'll show you how to create these template variables, and then I'll show you several different possible use cases and benefits to help you better understand why you may want to use them in your projects. Okay, let's start with the syntax. To create a template variable, we need to add the at symbol followed by the word let. The variables set with this let syntax are a lot like variables set using JavaScript's let declaration. So next, we need to add one or more white spaces, followed by a variable name, and then one or more white spaces again. Then, as with JavaScript variables, we set it using the equal sign, followed by a valid JavaScript expression. This expression can be a single or multi-line expression. And then we terminate the expression with a semicolon. So that's how we create them. Now let's take a look at a few use cases. Let's start with a real basic example to see it in action. Here in the header component, we're going to take the brand name PetPix and set it to a variable. To do this, let's create the variable using the let syntax. Let's call it name. Then let's set it to the string PetPix. Then we just need to add a semicolon. Now to use this variable, in this case, we can just string interpolate the value here. Okay, now let's save and see what happens. Okay, nothing happened, which is a good thing, right? It means that this variable has been set correctly and is working just as we'd expect. Now, this is just a simple example to demonstrate how this syntax works. The only reason I could see to make a variable for something this simple is if the brand name were to be used in more than one place in this template. So just keep that in mind. Okay, how about a little bit more of an advanced example? This new syntax can help simplify usages of observables that use the async pipe. For example, if we open up our slider component template, we have this selected image observable used to provide the image description to the description form component. This observable is updated every time we navigate to a new image. We're using the async pipe here in order to easily update the view when the observable emits with a new value. And we are also using the same variable and async pipe here to display the location the photo was taken in. Now, in the latest versions of Angular, you may find yourself using observables with the async pipe much less often because we can easily convert them to signals with the new toSignal function. And if you're doing this, this example won't really provide much value for you. But for those of you who are still using this configuration, we can simplify it a little with the let syntax. Let's add a new variable and we'll add it outside of this isAnonymous condition here. Let's call it image. And let's set it to our observable with the async pipe. Then let's add the nullish coalescing operator. And if it's undefined, we'll fall back to the first image in the list. And now we can remove this condition wrapping the description form because we'll always have an image and a description with how we've set our variable up. We can also eliminate this condition wrapping the location since we have our new variable. Okay, let's save and see how this works now. Nice, we have the description and the address. And when we switch images, the description and address updates correctly. So that's definitely better than it was before, but you just may not really need this depending upon your code base. So let's take a look at another example. With let, we can really clean up repetitive and complex template logic, making things easier to read, understand, and maintain. Let's look at our slider component template again here. Here we have a kind of long condition. We check to make sure the user is not anonymous. we check that the list length is greater than one, and we check that the account type is paid before we show the buttons to navigate the gallery. Now, not only is this a long, ugly condition, this exact condition is used to display the description as well. Well, this is another great use for the let syntax. Let's make this condition a variable. Let's add it at the top of the template. We'll call it advanced features. Okay, now we just need to update both of those conditions to use the new variable. Now, if we save, we should still see our navigation buttons and description form. And it looks like we do. Nice. So it's a great way to clean up repetitive and complex conditions. We can also do cool things like create dynamic variables based off things like the values from form controls. For example, let's take a look at our description form component. Here we have a text area with its value bound to a description input. Well, we can create a variable based off the value of this field. To do this, we first need to add a template reference variable in the text area itself. Then let's add a new variable called descriptionVal. We'll set this variable accessing the value property off of the reference variable for the text area. Now let's output the string interpolated value of this field here. Okay, now let's save and take a look. Cool, now we have the description value repeated out here. That's nice, right? But what's even more cool is that we can type in this text area, and when we do, we see the value change as we type. Very cool. So that may come in handy for you in certain situations. Something else we can do is use the let syntax for type narrowing on signal values. What exactly does this mean? Let's take a look at an example. Back in the example for our slider component, we actually already have a signal for the selected image that we can use instead of the observable. So we can eliminate this image variable that we created earlier and instead set the description with our selected image signal. Now what we can do is create a location variable. And we'll set this based off the signal instead, accessing the location object off the signal. This allows us to simplify the address and also allows us to eliminate the conditional check on each of these properties as well. So let's save and make sure it's still working correctly. Nice, everything looks good. So overall, this syntax can really just help simplify a lot of different things right within the component templates, and this is pretty handy. But there are a couple of things to be aware of. First, unlike JavaScript variables set using let, these template variables are read-only and cannot be reassigned. Now, they will update when the view changes, like what we see when the description input changes on our description form, but if we try to reassign the variable directly, we'll get an error. For example, if we try to redeclare this advanced features variable in our slider component, we won't be able to. Let's go ahead and set it to false. Now let's save and see what happens. And there we get an error letting us know that we can't declare this variable because it already exists. So that's something to be on the lookout for. Another thing to be aware of is that scope matters. Variables defined with let can only be accessed by the current view and its descendants. They cannot be accessed by any parent. An easy way to see this is to add a variable within an if block. Let's add a test variable here. Now let's try to access this variable outside of the scope of the if block. Now let's save and see what happens. There, we get an error when we try to do this because that variable is scoped within the condition and is not accessible outside. So this new concept, the ability to add variables right within the template, is pretty handy in some situations. Now I'm sure that there are several of you out there who may not be impressed or who may just dislike the idea of doing this altogether. And if you're one of these folks, that's fine. Just remember, it's okay. You don't have to use it. Just know it's there for you if you need it. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, check out my channel for more videos about various topics and features within Angular. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.